in the first draft, and I got better at this, because there are flat characters in Darkest Prayer. There are a couple that I look back on like, I should have fleshed him out better. But what I learned, and anybody listening that's an aspiring writer, it doesn't hurt to read books about writing. It doesn't hurt to take a class about writing. And I read a book called Story by Robert McKee. It's for screenwriting, but it's great for novel writing too. And he had this line in there about scenes should start one way and end differently. Mm. Should never end the scene flat. A scene should either start positively and end negatively, or start negatively and positively. And I took that and I extrapolated it for my purposes to characters. If you're a character's in a scene, they should start either at the bottom of the valley or at the top of the mountain. And then by the end of the scene, they're in a totally opposite place than where they started. And for that creates energy, that creates activity, not just physical, but emotional. And so, like, for instance, we'll take a scene. After this character named Ronnie Sessions, who comes to Beauregard, they've worked together in the past and didn't go well, but Beauregard's in a tight spot, so he listens to his proposal, wants to rob this jewelry store. The next morning after that scene, Ronnie's in a low spot because Bug hasn't agreed to do the job, to be the wheelman, and he's going over his head, I can't do it. My poor brother Reggie can't do it. You know, none of the people we hang out with have enough, you know, Ronnie's not super smart, but he's smart enough to know that he's dumb. And he's like, I can't do this. And he's sitting there kind of bummed out, and he's trying to think about how he's going to do this. And then his brother reminds him, hey, he told you to buy a burner phone and y'all could talk about it. You should call him. And then Ronnie's like, yeah, I'll call him. And when he calls him, then of course he doesn't know Bug has had some stuff happen where he's like, yeah, I'm going to have to do this. I'm going to have to make this work. And by the end of that scene, Ronnie's, you know, now he's, you know, 10 feet tall and bulletproof. He's called his on again, off again girlfriend. He's talking trash to her on the phone. He's trying to arrange a date later on. He's you know, he's happy because he this guy is going to help him out. And that's the scene. Like, again, it exemplifies what I'm talking about. Started out negative, end positive. So by the end of the scene, you've gone on an emotional journey with this character. And that really helped me going forward with stories. The book I worked on, I was talking about Razor Blade Tears, the book that I'm outlining now. And so I keep trying to do that. And it's something now that's become just a part of my, for lack of a better word, style. I don't have to think about it. I just do it. If a scene starts positively, ends negatively, or vice versa. Also, for me, and I get a lot of pushback on this from editors, but I like it, so I keep doing it. I like to give characters quirks, not quirks that are just physical quirks or tics, but things about them that are unique. And I think maybe that's a residual effect of my love of the Southern Gothic, you know. Like with Ronnie Session, he has 23 Elvis tattoos on his arm. I like describing the physicality of people, whether they're big, overweight, underweight, skinny, tall. I like talking about hands and faces and how people look. And, you know, that feeling where you're in the middle of a conversation and somebody says something, you're talking over each other, and you know, when you hear something you don't like and stuff like that. And so those things, too, help create characters that I hope are alive. I mean, you know, nobody's, you know, we're all struggling in the dark here, but I try to do that. And that's sort of, but yeah, Robin McKee's Story is a great resource for any aspiring writer.